Hello everyone. So let's get started with the next session on transmission and distribution, module 2. So the learning objectives of this particular session are, so you will be able to determine the capacitance in single phase and three phase lines, like how we solved some of the problems in the previous session. So we will continue with some of the problems on single phase and three phase lines, single circuit and double circuit lines. Also, you will be able to understand the concept of skin effect and proximity effect, and how would these two effects would affect the performance of the transmission line, and how to reduce, what are the options to reduce skin effect and proximity effect, we will be discussing in this particular session. Also, we will be able to compare single circuit and double circuit lines. How are they different? Okay, how are they different in their construction or configuration? So we will also get to know the comparison of single circuit and double circuit lines. So let's get started with the first problem. So in the first problem over here, you will be asked to determine the capacitance and the charging current per kilometer for a transmission line that is shown in the figure. And over here, the line is operating at 132 kV and the diameter, conductor diameter, is around 0.6 centimeters. Okay, and this is the diagram that is given. So you can clearly see the distance between the conductors A and B is 2 meters, between B and C is 4 meters, and again between A and C is 2 meters. So from the diagram, you got to know the value of DAB. The given value of DAB is 2 meters, and the value of DBC is 4 meters, and DCA is 2 meters. So the formula to find D equivalent over here is cube root of DAB, DBC, and DCA. So on taking the cube root for the values, you get a value of 2.51 meters. So conductor diameter is given in the problem. So value is around 0.6 centimeters. So therefore the radius of each of the conductor is 0.003 meters. And capacitance can easily be found from our derivations that we have discussed in our previous sessions. It is 2 pi epsilon naught divided by ln D equivalent by R farads per meter. So on simplification, this will be the value that we obtain for capacitance. And they have also used to ask you to find the value of charging current. To find the value of charging current, you are supposed to know the value of phase voltage. The phase voltage over here is V line divided by root 3. Okay, line voltage is equal to root 3 times of phase voltage. You will get around 76.1 kilo ohms. So what will be the charging current? You know, V is nothing but I times its reactance. So on substituting this, you will get a value of 76.1 into 2 pi into 50 is the frequency into the value of that epsilon. On simplification, you will get a value of IC is equal to 0.197 amperes per kilometer. Since they have asked you to find the charging current per kilometer, you are supposed to find it. Moving on to the next problem. So here a three-phase double circuit line arrangement is given, and you are supposed to find out the capacitance per phase to neutral. Okay, the radius of each of the conductor over here is also mentioned, that's given as 3 centimeter. Okay, so this is the arrangement that they have given. So the arrangement over here is, your distance between X and Y is around 2 meters, Y and Z is again 2 meters, and again Z to X dash is around 6 meters. So this is the distance. So this is the distance that is given, X to Y, Y to Z, again Z to X dash. So this unknown values you can easily find. So how will you find the value of X, Y dash here? You can apply trigonometric Pythagoras theorem, and you can clearly find out the values of unknown sides. Based on the derivations that we have discussed in the previous sessions, you can easily find out the value of D, G, and F. R is given in the problem. The capacitance of phase X with respect to neutral, the formula that we have derived previously in our previous session was 4 pi epsilon naught divided by ln 2 power 1 by 3 D G to the power of 2 by 3 divided by R F to the power of 2 by 3. On substituting these values, okay, you will get a final value as 2.563 into 10 power minus 11 farads per meter. This is the value for capacitance of a conductor X with respect to neutral. So this is the final value of capacitance that they have that we have converted into 2 microfarads per kilometer. Since they have asked you to find the value of kilo capacitance per kilometer, you can consider that. You can multiply it and find it for per kilometer. This is a simplification process. The next problem, the last problem pertaining to single and double circuit lines, finding the value of capacitance. In such type of problem, this is the last one. The six conductors of a double circuit three-phase line, the arrangement of this is as shown in the figure. So the diameter of each of the conductor that's given is 2.5 centimeter. You are supposed to find out the capacitance to neutral, assuming that the line is transposed. Okay, here you are assuming the line has to be transposed. Why is transposition important? Because transposition will give you a, usually you prefer transposition when the line, when the conductors are not uniformly spaced. If the conductors are not uniformly spaced, it's better to, it's always recommended to transpose the conductors. Why is it? Because you will have uneven distribution of inductances or capacitances in the line. That would have a greater impact on the performance of the line. As a result, transposition is recommended. So that problem will solve that kind of a problem over here. So this is the arrangement that is given. Just configure that is how a double circuit line is arranged. Similarly, you can find out the unknown using trigonometry, DAB value, DAB dash. DAB value is around 4.12 meters. DAB dash is around 8.94 meters. DAA dash is 10.63 meters. DCC dash is 10.63. How do you find the DAB for all the cases equivalent? So it's 4th root of DAB, DAB dash, DBA, and DBA dash. So its value is around 6.06 meters. And what is the value of DBC? 4th root of DBC, DBC dash, DCB and DCB dash. Okay. Again, its value is will amount to 6.06 meters. What is DCA here? It's 4th root of DCA, DCA dash, DAC and DCA dash. So its value is around 7.48 meters. Okay. So how do you find the GM? The GM value is again cube root of all the values that you have found. That is DAB, DBC and DCA. So its value will amount to 6.5 meters. And geometric mean radii, GMR1, you're supposed to find it for all the three positions. Like how we derived the same thing, the same derivation that we have done on a double circuit line. In similar grounds, using the same equations, you're solving the problems over here. So that is geometric mean radii 1 for position 1 is around 0.364 meters and for GMR2 for position 2 is around 0.335 meters and GMR3 is for position 3 is 0.634 meters. Now you can find out the equivalent cube root of GMR1, GMR2 and GMR3 and that value will amount to, on substituting these three values here, you will get a value as 0.354 meters. You know, to find the capacitance with respect to neutral, it's 2 pi epsilon naught divided by ln dm divided by ds. So this value, the denominator of this value dm by ds with respect to LAN, you will get it as 2.910. So on simplification, you will get a value of capacitance with respect to neutral as 0.019 nanofarads per meter. Next, we will move on to the next concept, that is bundled conductors. What are these bundled conductors? Bundled conductors usually are made up of two or more conductors. Okay, and usually if our intention is to transmit more power, we prefer bundled conductors. So it can either consist of configurations, can either be two stranded, three stranded or four strand conductors. Okay, and normally they are recommended if the line voltage value is above 220 kV. Bundle conductors are usually preferred to transfer power if the line is voltage is above 220 kV. Okay, so how do you configure a two-stranded, three-stranded and a four-stranded bundle conductor? A three-stranded bundle conductors, usually you are configuring it at the corners of the equilateral triangle. And a four conductor bundle conductors are placed, conductors over there are placed at the vertices of a square. It looks like a square. A three-stranded configuration will look like a triangle, and a two-stranded just like a line. We will just see the diagram. Okay, and over here, if you do not transpose the conductors within the bundle, again you will have unequal distribution of current. As a result, transposition is necessary. This unequal distribution of current will give you, because current is responsible for magnetic field and magnetic field for inductance, and current is responsible for electric field for capacitance, so you will have unequal distribution of inductances and capacitance in the line. As a result, transposition is necessary. So you will use the concept of geometric mean distance in order for the calculations pertaining to bundle conductors. Okay, so this is a two-stranded bundle conductor, this is a three-stranded bundle conductor, and this is a four-stranded bundle conductor. So it's looking like a line, two-stranded, three-stranded is looking like a triangle, and a four-stranded is looking like a square. So what is the calculations for GMR, geometric mean radius, if it is a two-strand bundle conductor? So this is the expression for a two-stranded bundle conductor, root of ds into d. So what would be the expression for a three strand bundle conductor? What would be the expression? So it is cube root of ds into d square. So what is the expression for a three strand, four strand bundle conductor? This was the expression for a three strand bundle conductor. What would be its value for a four strand bundle conductor? So if it is for a four-strand bundle conductor, expression is 1.09 fourth root of ds into d cube. This is the expression for GMR calculation for a four-strand bundle conductor. Let's solve a problem on this based on these calculations of a bundle conductor. So you have a figure over here. Each conductor of the bundle conductor has a geometric mean radius of 0.0172 meters. Over here, you are supposed to find out the inductive reactance per phase, and the D is value is given as 55 centimeters. You are also supposed to find the per unit series reactance. You should find inductive reactance XL, and you are also supposed to find the per unit series reactance of the line. For a line length of 160 kilometer and the base value is around 100 MVA at 220 kV. Okay, so let's get started with the problem. So for a two-stranded bundle conductor, you know the value of GMR is root of ds into d. Okay, so the ds value is given in the problem and d is also given, 55 centimeter. Convert it into meters, and on calculation you will get it as 0.097 meters. Okay, and also the GMD can easily be calculated as cube root of 9 into 9 into 18. This, you will get these values of 9, 9, and 18, you will get it from the diagram. And this value is around 11.33 meters. They also ask you to find out the inductive reactance, XL. That is 2 pi FL. So what is its value? The value of inductive reactance XL per kilometer is 0.299 ohm per kilometer per phase. What is the why do you require a base impedance? Because they have also asked you to find out the reactance per unit, considering the kilometer length and also the value of base MVA and kilovolt. So base impedance, you will get it as 484 ohms, and X per unit is 0.299 into 160 is a kilometer that they have given line length, divided by the base impedance value. You will get a value of X reactance, X value as 0.098 per unit. Let's start with the next and the important concepts, effects. How these two concepts affect the performance of the transmission line, that is the skin effect and the proximity effect. Okay, so in skin effect, okay, we will consider a DC current initially and an AC current initially. So you would have got to know that DC systems do not have skin effect. And why AC systems will experience a skin effect. Why is that? We will look into it. So whenever a DC current, when it starts flowing through a conductor, current will be uniformly distributed throughout its cross-sectional area. We will have uniform distribution of current throughout its cross-sectional area. That is, current density will be uniform throughout its cross-sectional area. But this will not happen. It will not happen in the same manner if it is an AC current. When AC current flows through a conductor, you will have uneven distribution of current throughout its cross-sectional area. Current will be unevenly be distributed. You will not have even distribution of current. You will not have same uniform current density. Okay. What is this uneven distribution of current leading to in a conductor when the AC current flows through it? The problem is the current gets concentrated on the surface of the conductor. You will not only on the surface of the conductor, you will have more concentration of current. Okay. You at the center, you will not have much. Okay. This phenomenon is called as skin effect. Okay. As I've already mentioned, because of the skin effect, current gets concentrated on the outer surface of the conductor, at the skin of the conductor. Outer surface is nothing but what? Skin of the conductor. As a result, it is called as skin effect. The depth to what level it is concentrating is denoted as delta. So as I've already mentioned, the red mark over here, you have current density at the outer surface. Current gets accumulated more at the skin of the conductor or at the outer surface of the conductor. You will have very less concentration of current at the coarse part, at the center part. Okay, and this part is called as delta. We'll give you the accumulation of current at the outer surface of the conductor. Okay, conductors usually in wires are normally cylindrical in cross section. Okay, and whatever the wire that you consider as a conductor, they're normally cylindrical in cross section. Assume that, for the sake of analysis, you are splitting the solid conductor into number of filaments or strands. The solid conductors are split into number of filaments or strands. As when you split them up, current will also get split up. So each strand will carry their own current. Okay. The inductance of each strand will automatically start varying according to its position of the conductor, because current is responsible for magnetic field, and magnetic field will correspond to inductance. And this will also start varying, because since it is getting divided into number of strands, you will have variations over here also. Okay, conduct strands that are located at the center would be surrounded by a greater magnetic flux. As a result, you will have more inductance near the surface. Because wherever you have more accumulation, it gives rise to more amount of magnetic field, and as a result, you will also get inductance. Higher the value of inductance, okay, of the inner strand, causes alternating current to flow through the strands, having lower reactance near the surface. Okay, so however, what the accumulation or the concentration of current at the skin or at the outer surface is denoted by delta. Okay, this is the expression. So you have root of 1 divided by pi f mu and conductivity rho. So what is f here? Frequency of current. Mu is permeability of the conductor material, and sigma is the conductivity of the conductor material. So you will get to know now skin effect depends on frequency and type of conductor material. So as in DC, you don't have frequency, you cannot expect the concept of skin effect in DC. Okay, that is the reason you will have uniform distribution of current in DC. Current density will be uniform in DC because of the absence of frequency. Delta is nothing but the skin depth or the accumulation level. That is totally dependent on F, mu and conductivity. So on what factors does skin effect depend? So main thing is the type of conductors. So conductor will correspond to conductivity. Ferromagnetic materials will conduct permeability, and these would greatly affect skin effect. And the value of mu and conductivity sigma will greatly affect the skin effect. Very less value of delta implies more current density. As a result, current skin effect will also be more. Effective resistance will also be more. So more effective resistance, what will be the problem that you face? The more effective resistance means more heat, more power loss. I square R, P is equal to I square R. Effective resistance increases, power loss will also increase. Heat dissipation will increase. That is a problem. As a result, one should pay much attention, more attention in designing a line, transmission line. Skin effect will also increase with the increase in cross-sectional area. As already mentioned, as frequency increases, more accumulation of current on the outer surface or at the skin will increase. Shape of the conductor also. Solid conductors will experience more skin effect. Stranded will experience less skin effect. As a result, ACSR conductors, in the module 1 you would have studied about types of conductor. Aluminium conductors, aluminium conductors, steel reinforced are usually recommended. Even they are recommended even to prevent or reduce sag in lines. They are also recommended to reduce skin effect. And you can use a material that has a lesser diameter and a non-magnetic conductor like copper. If it's magnetic, you will have ferromagnetic materials, permeability will be more. So that would also cause skin effect by the expression that we saw. So if you use a material that is made up of copper, obviously you can somehow reduce the skin effect. And preferably using ACSR conductors, skin effect will also be reduced. Because in solid conductors, skin effect will be more. The next concept is proximity effect. What is this proximity effect? When a two or more conductors, you will have two or more conductors always in a pole or in a line. So when these carry current close to each other, the distribution of current amongst the two conductors gets affected. Why will the distribution of current amongst the two conductors gets affected? Because of the varying magnetic field with respect to each other, two or more conductors, obviously distribution of current will also vary. So this varying magnetic field that is produced by the current, because current is responsible for magnetic field, okay, this will induce eddy currents in adjacent conductors. Eddy currents will again give rise to eddy current loss, okay. And again, the problem over here is when the nearby conductors are carrying current in the same direction, current gets concentrated on the farther side. Okay, when these two conductors are carrying current in the same direction, currents get concentrated at the farthest side. Whereas when these two nearby conductors are carrying current, and if it's in opposite direction, current gets concentrated at the nearest part of the conductors. If it in the same direction, current gets concentrated farthest side. If it is nearby and if it is in opposite direction, the current gets concentrated at the nearest parts, and that effect is called as proximity effect. And major problem is the effect increases with the increase in frequency. As already mentioned, effective resistance will also increase, and at higher frequency AC resistance will be 10 times more than DC resistance because of the skin effect and proximity effect. The effective resistance will be more than the DC resistance because of the skin and proximity effect. Even the effective resistance will be more, obviously the loss will be more. This increase in resistance, as already mentioned, will increase the power loss. It will increase the power loss and also the undesirable heating. You will have more heat that is generated, and hence it has to be taken care of. At radio frequencies, Q factor of the inductance gets reduced because of this proximity effect, and it will also increase the bandwidth. Because you deal with magnetic field and magnetic field proximity effect, and you deal with magnetic field will give rise to inductance. Q factor of the inductors gets reduced, which later increases the bandwidth. And this effect of proximity effect has to be taken into consideration, especially while designing a high frequency transformers and inductors. Proximity effect, both skin and proximity effect, has to be considered in designing. We should keep into consideration while designing high frequency transformers and inductors, more closely the proximity effect. Let's move on to the last topic of today's session, that is advantages of single circuit and double circuit. You don't find a major advantage. It's just a configuration of line, and there are reasons why we should use single circuit and why you should use double circuit. When the reasons are very much particular, you cannot say this is better or that is better, because it depends upon your application or place or wherever you want single circuit. Just because a double circuit can transfer more power, you cannot use them. Okay, so it's just a mere comparison of single circuit and double circuit lines. Okay, usually they're meant to carry power, and you need not confuse single circuit line with a single phase line. They're different. Single circuit will have only one circuit, and over here each tower carries three conductors. We will see the diagram. A double circuit, as the name indicates, will have two such circuits. Each tower over here will carry six. Single circuit will have three, double will obviously have six, 3 × 2. So this is how a single circuit and double circuit look like. This is a representation, pictorial representation of single circuit and double circuit lines. So as I already mentioned, single circuit will have three conductors for three phases, whereas double circuit will support six conductors. Double circuit lines are usually preferred where reliability is of utmost importance. Okay, where reliability is very much significant or necessary, double circuit lines are preferred. And again, as already mentioned, if your intention is to transfer more power over a particular distance, double circuit lines are preferred. Okay, and the major advantages of double circuit lines are power transmission will be economical and they require less space. Power transmission will be economical and they require less space when you compare it with single circuit lines. And the major problem of double circuit lines is inductive coupling. Since you have two circuits operating close to each other, there will be a problem of inductive coupling. And this is a major issue, especially you have to consider it in designing the protective schemes and also while calculating the fault level. Inductive coupling, effect of inductive coupling has to be taken into consideration. Double circuit lines are made up of bundle conductors. Why are they made up of bundle conductors? Because you can reduce the value of inductance. To summarize the today's session, the concepts that we discussed in today's session. So in the beginning, we just discussed the problems pertaining to single circuit and double circuit lines, and later we had an option to discuss the concepts of skin effect and proximity effect. How would these two effects affect the performance of the transmission line? And at last, we also compare single circuit and double circuit lines, considering their advantages and disadvantages. Thank you.